The skies above Europe are becoming increasingly congested, as are Europe's major airports. This growth in air traffic means all airports need to be safely accessible at all times. EGNOS, the European Geostationary Navigation Overlay Service, offers enhanced vertical as well as horizontal precision and integrity, improved safety, accessibility and efficiency for operators, pilots and airports across Europe. EGNOS is a satellite-based augmentation system that improves GNSS positioning using three satellites and a network of more than 39 reference stations in 24 countries. But how can EGNOS make a difference? EGNOS improves safety by providing pilots with reliable and accurate vertical guidance, increasing situational awareness and reducing workload.
If you can improve the safety of one of the most critical phases of flight, being the approach, you basically improve overall flight safety.
There are many benefits of LPB procedures as part of the PBN concept. LPB increases safety thanks to accurate vertical guidance.
EGNOS also acts as a backup for ground-based systems and is a key element of air traffic management. EGNOS is providing reliable positioning for ADS-B. This is a new cooperative surveillance technology in which an aircraft determines its location using satellite positioning and periodically broadcasts it, enabling it to be tracked.
It's fundamental to what we do, it's fundamental to enabling ADS-B, and it's going to be fundamental to the future technologies that develop post-ADS-B for the European airspace.
EGNOS is a cost-effective alternative to ILS Cat 1, offering similar performance without the need for costly ground-based infrastructure and maintenance. In fact, the PBN regulation approved by the European Commission in 2018 opened up a new paradigm for European air traffic, leading to EGNOS approaches to all airports by 2024 and supporting the rationalization of conventional nav aids. We're moving to a full PBN environment, enabled by European GNSS, by 2030.
You can fly a continuous descent, so you don't need to add thrust for any level off or for lower or change the rate of descent. It's more stable and therefore more economic.
The LPV approach allows us to make ILS look-alike approaches with the same minimas, allowing the same service to the passengers, but without the ground-based aids.
We can design more direct procedures, reducing fuel consumption and therefore emissions. We also have the possibility of designing curved segments to prevent overflight of populated areas and reduce noise.
The lower decision heights enabled by EGNOS can also reduce costly delays, diversions and cancellations. All that's needed is an onboard EGNOS certified receiver, an adapted procedure for the runway end, and an adapted flight management system. For pilots, flying EGNOS approaches only requires limited training and will in many cases be smoother than using an ILS.
Once you practice it and you perform it, it's quite simple. You feel that flight path is smoother and the maneuvers are smoother than flying an ILS.
With an EGNOS procedure, even small and medium-sized airports and heliports remain accessible, even in poor weather conditions.
The SLS satellite landing system is very successful on the A350XWB, with more than 60% selection rate. We already have customers for the introduction of the SLS on the A320. Customers are very happy that we have decided to launch this function, because it offers them the extended possibility to land pretty much anywhere.
LPV approach procedures can go down as low as an ILS Cat 1 minimum. That means the approach operations will be much more robust with a lower minimum.
If you have the procedures, you can arrive to the hospital in a known time. If you don't have the procedures, you don't know how long it will take to the hospital.
The EGNOS approach appears as an ideal alternative. Now, the ATC is confident about the fact that we have a procedure that can substitute the conventional approaches. It opens opportunity to improve.
EGNOS can also reduce the impact of aviation on the environment by facilitating curved approaches and continuous descent paths, and therefore reduce both noise and emissions.
Efficiency, that means shorter flight times, less fuel burn, less impact on the environment, and these are direct benefits that we get on a daily basis.
For helicopters, EGNOS allows custom approach procedures to be developed from any direction, using steeper approaches than those flown by fixed-wing aircraft, thereby avoiding densely populated areas. This is especially relevant for emergency and rescue operations, where EGNOS enables operations anywhere, anytime, and in any weather conditions. EGNOS was certified for civil aviation in 2011. As of mid-2019, 650 procedures were published and many more under development. Over the years, the performance of EGNOS has also been improved, including the launch of LPV-200. The majority of navigation systems in today's aircraft and helicopters now integrate EGNOS, and many airlines now fly EGNOS approaches across Europe.
Already now we're making LPV approaches in more than 20 airports within our route network, and we're doing this on a daily basis.
What we're starting to see now is the uptake of ESPAS and EGNOS-enabled receivers into commercial aeroplanes.
In the business aviation, we fly these approaches on a daily basis. It gives us more autonomy, it's safer, it gives us the same minimums. And the more we fly it, the more we like it. Our pilots are really delighted to fly LPV approaches.
EGNOS is still improving. EGNOS version 3, which will integrate Galileo, is under development. And EGNOS will be extended possibly beyond Europe. EGNOS can provide accessibility, safety and cost savings in a single proven solution by delivering high precision with a low investment.